Before I begin, there is no email attachment limit, unless you set one through mail throw rules. There is, however, a message size limit which can be set on a few levels. In organization transport setting, in send and receive connector settings, and in user mailbox settings. You can set all those limits using Exchange Admin Center, but it is more convenient to use PowerShell. This way you can check and set everything from one place. All cmdlets used in the video are available in the description. After you connect to your Exchange or Exchange Online organization, you can use the following cmdlets to check all active message size limits. As you can see, users don't have the limit configured. Still, they won't be able to send emails larger than those specified on a higher level. To change the maximum email size on any level, I can, for example, pipeline get-mailbox to set-mailbox and specify the new limit. Now, to set a limit specifically for attachments, I have to create a new mail throw rule. Let's do it in PowerShell as well. I create a new transport rule, name it, set the maximum attachment size, and specify the notification the sender will receive when an email is blocked. The rule will appear in Exchange Admin Center, as if it was created there from the very beginning. Now, whenever users try to send an attachment which is too large, they will get a failure notice. If you need an advanced mail flow manager for the on-premises Exchange, try out Code2 Exchange Rules Pro. This software lets you take full control over your mail flow. It manages your attachments and unifies the look of your corporate correspondence with centrally managed email signatures. Click a link in this video's description to learn more and download a free trial.